Hey everybody! Well, you win some in Afterbirth, plus you lose some in Antibirth. That's the way it's been going lately. Dare we? No. Slow your roll. I'm so salty that Blue Baby run ended in despair. But dare I just go straight back to Bethany? It's an endless parade of Bethany, Blue Baby, and Jacob and Esau and the beating of that dang the heart! 8ARR4MFE. Alright, what's the rub here as Bethany? Damn dog, I don't know. Just try not to die as long as possible. We're trying to get the alt path. Wait a minute, there's a spirit art back there. Wait a minute, this isn't my world! Jacob and Esau! Did you see? I dodged the bullet with the fire. It is a new era, and you know what? The wafer? Pretty good as well. So I'm thinking right off the bat, we stack up as many fires as possible. The key does allow us to get access to the first alt floor, which we don't have to, but we should. I've had some people be like, NL, you're getting ground down in both games by the constant need to achieve. It's a problem that has dogged me throughout my entire life, is the need to be successful by conventional means. That's why I found myself in the career that I'm in. I said, you know what? Going to college, becoming a doctor, that's too easy. Playing video games on the internet, now that's something I aspire to do. We're gonna go back and check these tinted rocks, largely for small rock prospects, but there's a really good one right here. This actually comes up quite often when new Isaac content comes out. People go, hey, you know, like just by definition most of the time, or by default, the final challenges that are left, not challenges, but the final tasks that remain to get completion are usually quite difficult. They tend to be the most difficult. They get sorted till the end because, you know, you don't want to do them at the start because you just fail them, which is also acceptable, you know, it's the first step on the way to greatness. However, we are eventually just going to be left, in all likelihood, with a bunch of characters that we're not very good with. And that's just the way that the cookie crumbles. It's kind of why in Afterbirth Plus I'm saving, like, I know there's challenges that are related to daily challenges, and I'm kind of saving those challenges in the hopes that maybe that'll provide a nice way for me to segue from, like, being task-oriented into a more evergreen style of just constantly making content. But yeah, basically what I'm getting at is, whenever there's a lot of stuff to get done, I'll take a tiers upgrade. It's not actually a tiers upgrade? How many times have I gone down this road? I like it when it's task-oriented, because it's not task-oriented forever. It's actually a very special time that I wish it could last. You know, being task-oriented in Isaac means there's new content. New content means we're kind of out of our element, which I think is mostly good. Yeah, I don't mind this that much. I could use the bombs, to be honest with you, so hopefully we get some kind of delicious bomb synergy or, you know, other such related consumable that maybe starts with a B and ends with a nom. Banana bombs. Nah, there's that can't... Lip bomb. There you go. Doesn't start with a B, but you get the idea. I gotta admit that for, like, the first maybe 26 years of my life, I had no idea what lip balm was used for. That doesn't mean I had not used it. We'll just use this, speaking of which, because we don't really have much else to gain, I suppose. That doesn't mean that I had never used it. I just didn't really understand what it was for. Like why... It's the same as antacid when I was younger. I was like, why does granddad always have a pack of Rolaids? You know, you get old, you get indigestion. It's a lifetime of bad habits coming back to bite you in the ass. Now you gotta pay 75 cents a week for Rolaids, you know, or Tums or whatever. I've been there. However, lately, I don't know. I think I've started to understand the lip balm industry. Sometimes when I go to bed, I'm like, my lips are a little chapped. Got a little tube of Blistex over there. Put it on. Wake up in the morning. Don't feel like P. Diddy. Unless P. Diddy has particularly well-moisturized lips, which, to be honest with you, wouldn't surprise me. He's worked in the entertainment industry for a long time. We've probably been exposed. Because we've probably been exposed to a lot of the same influences. Me and P. Diddy, we're basically like, you know, pretty much on the same page. We're both moguls. Both long-storied relationship with Jennifer Lopez. We both starred in the 2010 film Get Him to the Greek. Released to surprise critical acclaim. Well, co-starred. He co-starred, I starred. Yes, that's correct. I am Jonah Hill. Alright. Well, I don't really want to teleport, so makes it an easy decision. We'll take a tiers upgrade that apparently this time is actually a tiers upgrade. Thanks for something, for once. I wanted to check and see if we would get the secret room there. Dude, tinted rocks coming fast and furious right now. We got a nice protection, not against contact damage, but against bullets, and I'm gonna enjoy that while it lasts, quite honestly. I'm gonna also preserve a lot of spirit hearts. Get away from my fires. The idea here is that if we have enough spirit hearts to deal damage, I want to make sure we qualify for the alt path that's coming up in like four floors. So honestly, I think right now it's going really well. And if we play our cards right, we should be guaranteed a deal. If it's a deal with the angel, that's fine by me. Will I fight the angel statue? That one's a little bit more suspect. I'm not looking to make my life any harder than it has to be, you know? Dude, Beelzebub is so easy if you kill him before he jumps. If he jumps before you kill him, better hope luck's on your side. Okay, we got the angel room. And a magic 8 ball. She's giving us a death card. And Guardian Angel, I'm for it. I don't think we want to fight this guy. I mean, just to get another spirit heart or something like that, I'm not interested. I will try the pill. Luckily, we didn't take it. Remember, luck is on your side. Haha, really worked out for us that time. Really worked out for us that time. Good joke. It's a good joke. We have a lot of those on this show. Tell you what, crank out this death card down here. Okay, there must be a champion or something, because the doors did not open. You know what? Knock him out like that. You kidding me? Come on, dude. There we go. No keys, unfortunately. I will take that, though. So far, so good. And honestly, a 40% chance of picking up a deal is actually very good. So I'm not going to sweat the fact that, you know, no goat head equals no guaranteed deal. Not to mention, like, you probably don't need me to tell you this, but deals with the angel tend not to be that good. Another reason not to, compared to deals with the devil, there are some items, I'm not saying they're all getting painted with the same brush here. You know, if you want to give me a sacred heart, basically sign me up. I'm interested in working for your organization. Is this how a Bethany run is supposed to be? Like, you're supposed to be immune to bullets? Why is this the first time I've ever experienced this on a run? Operator error? Probably operator error. Error between keyboard and monitor. Doesn't make any sense. Somebody corrected me on that phrase and I was like, oh, now I get it. And then I've forgotten it. That's my bad. Come on, small rock. We're gonna get it eventually. You might as well just give us small rock right now, as far as I'm concerned. We still cannot get into any room that requires a key, which is a bummer. This is gonna be a Sephiroth room. AKA enemies are why Sephiroth? I don't know. Kate just started calling that one Sephiroth. And now this is a Sephiroth room. And now our, you know, earworms for personal use only can be thus virulently broadcast to, you know, tens of thousands of people out there. You can all call them earworms, and then when someone who, or call them Sephiroths. And then when somebody who actually knows what they're talking about is like, well, actually in the bestiary, they're called, you know, drowned wanderers. You go, what are you talking, nobody calls them that. Okay, we might as well fight the boss, why not? The Rainmaker. Actually, wow. One of my favorite downpour bosses to fight, because it's actually one of the easiest to dodge. As long as you can dodge that Monstro shot and you don't stand too close to the arms, like right there, you're usually pretty good. So I'm stoked. We got through it. We did get a deal with the angel. We are going to get a key out of the box as well. I don't know, we shouldn't take the pill yet. We actually got a golden key. And then credit card. Of these, I would rather have the mind. But I'll admit that Guardian Shield or Trinity Shield can be very good as well. We didn't get a key, we got a golden key. Right, alright. We got credit card, which, if we're not going to get a deal with the devil, which is, I mean, we can plausibly get a deal with the devil, but if we're not going to get a deal with the devil, and we're going to rely on deals with the angel, I'm going to use the credit card right now to buy everything in here. And Nun's Habit is a pretty good item, I think, in conjunction with what we got going on. Also got an I Found Pills card, a bomb, a key, and a spirit heart. So we got a nice selection of charges stacked up here. We also can gain access to the boss trap room, which we are going to endeavor to do. Tears down, sucks real bad. Range up is fine. I Found Pills does nothing. Kind of a shitty haul. I hate that we've gotten a tiers upgrade. Two tiers upgrades, one tiers downgrade, and our tier stat is lower than it was at spawn. That's basically horse hockey as far as I'm concerned. Tell you what. One spirit heart normally would make this room worth doing, but because we're playing as Bethany, the math is a little twisted. So instead, I'm just going to use that. I'm going to turn that into fire immediately. In fact, we should probably turn more spirit hearts into fire immediately. Because the more we do here, the faster we're going to kill rooms. Just a smart idea, I think, to make sure we don't eventually, run out of fires. There might be like a good equilibrium point because, I mean, I don't want either of these. This is showing up like all the time lately, these fucking like book rooms. With 0.85 speed, I don't think we benefit from Samson's chain that much. I think largely we're just punished by it. Now, I want to deflect cries of NL, like where did your zaniness go? But like, Samson's chain is not zany. It's literally just a weight attached to your leg if you don't have the speed necessary to like whip it around. So, feel like it's a sensible option to not go with that. We don't know this, so I think we'll just take this down on the next floor. No tinted rocks, and we're good. I think the run's going fine so far. I almost don't want to take this pill yet because it could be a bad trip. But we do have a dice room. What kind of dice room would we like right now? I guess a 5-room or a 4-room is the best. It's a 4-room. Okay, this is actually pretty good. One thing that's been very annoying is that we can really only justify going to the curse rooms after we've already been hit. This room, by the way, is horrible. Because if we go before we get hit, then we're ruining our combined devil and angel chance. Yeah, this room is a fucking garbage fire, man. That's fine. Just wait it out slightly longer. I'm amazed we made it through there, but it's not without losing a few fires, so. Dude, we have to go Ipecac. I mean, Eyesore could be fun as well, but Ipecac is like, it's so amazingly good. We have to roll with it. And certainly, there was not much reason to reroll that one. I don't buy this right now. I don't buy this. What do I mean when I say I don't buy this? Those enemies were not dying in one Ipecac hit. Our damage is 43.5. You want to tell me those enemies live through an Ipecac hit? I don't buy it. You can show me the numbers. Jerry Maguire. I don't buy it. What do those enemies have? A million HP each? I'm gonna take the left hand over Swallowed Penny. We know what bosses we're fighting. Like, it's gotta be, especially on a big room, Great Gideon. I guess there are boss fights that are like, oh no, combinations of earlier bosses. Come on, dude. I think we should just go fight them right away. It's tough twins, right? Okay, actually Ipecac should smoke them, but Ipecac did not smoke them. I'm confused, but I accept my own ineptitude in the face of this confusion. Might want to stand further away from things that can explode in our face. Either way, I still want to, you know, try this devil chance if possible. I had a feeling that was going to happen. I don't know, the explosions do damage, but it doesn't break their armor. It's weird. I mean, it's working fine. Just a matter of whether. Oh, lordy. No longer working fine. Come on, 5% deal chance. I believe. You know what we actually need? And this... Wow.
We got the deal?
Okay, disregard. I can no longer complain. Although I'm still going to, because... Are you kidding me? You're gonna give me, experimental pill. Shot speed down is not that bad. HP up is good if we can get our HP back. You're not gonna let me leave the room. Not gonna let me leave the room. That's extremely bad. What I was gonna say is I'm pissed off because, we're going to have, I guess we should just go. That's a real bummer. I'm pissed off because we should have had a higher rate of fire. Like, I don't understand if that one tiers upgrade... It's probably working and just not showing me that it's working. Like, it's probably... Maybe it's lowering our tier delay cap or something like that, but... Still pissing me off. So we've lost, like, completely our economy. In terms of... Oh, no. We've lost our economy completely. In terms of blue fires. But all we really need to do is live, get some red hearts back. We got extremely fortunate to get, to get that deal with the devil. We had a 4% chance, sorry, deal with the angel. We had a 4% chance, a 5% chance of getting any deal. A 4% chance of getting an angel specifically, which is a little easier to stomach. Because of the fact that, obviously, it comes with, no cost associated with it. The downside is that, actually, it ended up not being worth very much at all. Because it's just spirit hearts, but... Life goes on. I mean, we're still picking them up to this day. So they must be doing something right, you know? Thank you for doing that. Thank you for giving me flies, which allowed me to kill the spiders more easily. So we'll place a bomb to not put ourselves too much in harm's way. Let me guess. More spirit hearts. We really should, use more to, like, get more fires. And in this case, this is really just, like, self-defense. If we don't create more fires, we will probably die. Didn't get him. We will probably die because an enemy that gets close to us is just gonna, you know, blow us out of the water. Another spirit heart. All-time classic. Thanks, really appreciate it. Now, the rosary does nothing for us, so we pretty much have to go... In fact, it's only a negative unless we want charges, so we pretty much have to go for speed plus range here. Not that I dislike it to begin with, but... It's not my number one choice in anti-birth because... Ooh, there we go, curved horn. It's not my number one choice in anti-birth because there are no... there's no spun transformation. Now, I'm not... As bad as I... Let's rephrase. As bad as I can be at Isaac from time to time, I'm not necessarily a stupid man. So I look at this right now and I go, there's no fucking way I'm fighting this boss. Do you know how many times I've died... With, like, 5 HP against the Mines bosses? The answer is, enough that I don't want to do it ever again. So, rather than being my typical self and going in there because I'm confident in my Isaac play, which I'm really not right now, I'm going to be smarter, back off, and I did hurt myself in the process, but I still stand by this being the right decision. I think if I had gone in there, I would have been killed. Red hearts, please. Red hearts just do not exist. At some point, I have to ask, is it me? I mean, I did take more damage than is, What can you do? What can you do? Ruka, what can you do, buddy? I know what happened. The one on the left, I thought I was far enough that it wouldn't proc, and it proc, not proc, but it activated. You know what? No, not doing Curse of the Giant. You've done this to yourself, Bethany. W7MJYJKH. I like you, Antibirth. I do. Sincerely. Sometimes, and you know what? I can't complain that much about Antibirth, although it did give me the rosary in our first item room. I can't complain that much about Antibirth because I took a pill that ended up being locked down. Was the whole thing out of my hands? No. I could have not taken that luck downgrade pill, and then conceivably, I might have had a small chance to get a red heart. And then if you get a red heart, you know, you fight the boss, maybe you get a deal with the angel. That's where Sacred Heart is. You just had to play perfectly for one more floor and you would have had it, right? It's the way it always goes. But I gotta be honest, dude. Like, as much as I like Antibirth, Jacob and Esau, beautiful character. I love it. I'm gonna open this. Fuck you. Fuck you and your alt path, basically. I'll take the devil card. Doesn't bother me in the least. Jacob and Esau, if we end up playing this mod, like, long term, I will play as, not all the time, but on the regular. Bethany, I never want to see again. It's like a full-on Lilith situation where I'm like, you know, I appreciate the ability that she has. I like her item. I like her item, but the fact that she can never pick up Spirit Hearts makes her a non-starter for me. I do appreciate, though, that we have Spectral Tears. But I don't know. Bethany, for me, I'm gonna stop short of saying she needs to be rebalanced. I just think, you know, if you want her to not be bad, she could be rebalanced. If not, if you want her to be bad, that's fine. I can understand that. I mean, we don't really benefit at all from taking... we can't get through there. We need three bombs. We don't benefit at all from taking Forget Me Now. Well, we do benefit. We get one extra first floor. Do we want one extra first floor at the cost of our spacebar item? Traditionally, no. If I'm being a silly boy, perhaps. Either way, though, we gotta do this. Like, I can't escape that. So, we might as well just embrace the misery here to some extent. That's actually a really good get right now. So, we get the key. Are you a wizard? Is annoying. I guess we might as well take Mysterious Paper, even though I don't even understand what it does to this day. But, no, don't open a golden chest. You're good. Go down to the next floor. Again, embrace the misery. There's only one way out. You gotta do it. At some point, you gotta do it. Stay away from me, please. I really don't think I'm strong enough to, stand a good chance to not take damage on this floor. What is it? What's the rule with Bethany when you have Are You a Wizard lasts 18 times longer? There we go. Get a Spirit Heart. At least get one more fire out of that. Like, part of the reason that... Like, look at this. What can you do? Stay away from me. This is a bad thing that's happening right here. At least these guys can't come over rocks. That would be the end of our existence, but... This is still too far. I respect and appreciate it, but... Stop. Get some help. Get a single Spirit Heart, so we get a fire back. I mean, the fires are not good in a vacuum. They're good exclusively in aggregate, basically. It's like having a brother Bobby. Or it's like having like 1/4 of a brother Bobby. At least it worked. We can't even get to that, I think, so... My hunch was correct, and they put the tricky room before the item room, so... I'm just gonna take it slow here. This run is, I would say, substantially worse than the last one. We gotta try. Again, just when Afterbirth Plus starts to pop off for me, not that we've exclusively succeeded, but we've had some good runs lately. Just when Afterbirth Plus starts to pop off, Antibirth starts to screw me a little bit. Now, these are all, both good items. Gimpy could have been great as well, but... I think we made the right play to take Capricorn. It's not even, like, contentious. Capricorn will be considered the right play there. I'm positive. I hate you so much. What happened to you to make you what you are? You didn't have to pick up that TNT and throw it at me when I have a speed stat of 0.95. Man, NL, you always complain about your speed now. What happened? Missing odd happened. It gave me just enough information to be dangerous. Now I know and have... Oh, that one was me, though. I have an ability to diagnose problems with my run that are not simply operator error, to use the words of a wise man. Still, actually, 45% deal with the devil chance, deal with the angel chance, I should say, is not bad. I walked right into that horrible dodging habit. This boss pretty much ruins Bethany's life because, yeah, I mean, it's not conceivable that your fires will survive. There's just damage is coming in from too many angles here. Still, we have a 1 in 4 chance of at least getting some kind of deal. Please disappear. Well, let's not even talk about a fucking deal. Let's just... Yeah, okay. Let's just live. And we get these spirit arts that provide us with zero value. I don't like it right now. I don't like it. Did I make some mistakes there? Did I do that? No, I did. There's no doubt I made some mistakes there. I'll be the first to tell you. I know that wasn't going to give us a black heart, but I was hoping we'd get 3 cents back here, and we did, so we can at least start to rebuild. I'm displeased. It just lowers the margin for error so much, but again, self, you don't have to do the alt path the whole time. You just have to do it. Please don't. You just have to do it on every second floor, and then don't fuck up the mausoleum. So maybe, I mean, the thing is though, like, I don't want to do that, right? Like, I want to do alt path the whole way because the alt paths are challenging. But now it becomes like, hey, you're like creating your own problem here. You're creating your own frustration. I have an incredibly high degree tolerance for frustration. That might surprise you because you hear me complaining a lot, especially recently. However, think of the way that I solve problems. I just bash my head against them doing the same thing until it works and brute force it instead of coming up with a clever solution. So, it's not in my DNA to not have patience for failure. Because if I didn't have patience for failure, I would just be angry all the time. So I know that given enough time, we will find the sweet spot that makes this run work. In the interim period, might annoy the Christ out of me a little bit, but there's another enemy. But we're gonna get there eventually. Daddy Longlegs, look, I know we need bombs in order to get to the alt path. Daddy Longlegs is an exquisite item. We need it. And Capricorn plus Daddy Longlegs means no more complaining for a bit here. Which means no more commentary for a bit at all, apparently. No, 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 this is... It's just good right now. What am I looking for beyond that? I mean, if I could get a pill that's a luck upgrade, we're starting to feel like we're way ahead of the curve. And the alt path and anti-birth has kind of forced me to rethink the way that I conceptualize runs. Because normally, if you went through your first three floors, you had Daddy Longlegs, Black Candle, Capricorn, you'd be like, we won. We won the run. We have nothing to concern ourselves with. But that's not the case anymore. For many reasons. Some of which are related to the world's most annoying bosses on the mine. Some of which are related to the world's most annoying enemies on the area directly preceding the mine, aka where we are right now, shall remain nameless. Let's go see if we at least get a deal. Beelzebub, the only concern is making sure he doesn't jump on you. Daddy Longlegs got us covered. Thank you. HP plus luck. I love it. A deal with the angel for Godhead. Don't even have to look at the other items. Okay. Now, even if we can't go down to the alt path, we won't be able to go down to the alt path immediately. You can just run the math on that yourself. We just need to get one bomb on the next floor. We could look for a second secret room. I think we should just head downwards. We got our knife piece, we've got Godhead. Is that what it takes? I hope. I hope that is what it takes. Is it sad that it took that? Maybe. But here we are. We basically picked up not the best item in the game, but one of the best items and one of the most fun items to see, if only because it's so rare. I mean, I don't know where else I was supposed to stand there. I'm not trying to be negative, but also big ups to the Antibirth devs for recognizing, you know, deals with the angels sort of suck. You know, it'd be sweet. How about we give you a selection of three items? You only get to choose one. That's a cool way to approach it. See, the way that a deal with the devil works is we'll give you a selection of items, usually, and you can take however many you want slash can afford. On angel rooms, it's kind of a cool analog there, or a cool flip on it, or twist on it, as you say in English. It's, you know, we'll show you a selection of items, but you can only choose one. I like it. Mostly I like it because it gave me Godhead. If it had given me a few shitty items to choose from, I'd probably be like, man, deals with the angels suck. But because it worked, I am excited. We're not gonna get punished that much. We're still gonna have, like, roughly close to a 50% chance of getting a deal here. And if it's a deal with the devil, dude, I'm actually still, like, super okay with that because we've got enough HP. Even Godhead, I mean, I gotta say, 5.19 damage, unless Godhead has a little something extra in the tank. I mean, it does, homing tears, and also a larger hitbox, but I hesitate to say it, not a run winner by itself. Makes almost everything better, but in a vacuum, not necessarily a run winner, but we still have, you know, we got Capricorn going along with it, and Daddy Longlegs, and, you know, I'm not gonna give Bloodclot too much credit, but we do have Bloodclot. We did get a deal. We also got an evil upgrade plus some bombs. Start saving these spirit hearts, because it looks like we will need them. I mean, okay, I'll tell you what, I'll take the spirit sword. And it's a terrible decision, because it takes away our Godhead tiers. No, it doesn't. It just gives us a sword that has Godhead effect. Alright. So, on this floor, we need... This is good practice for that challenge that I can't seem to beat as well. We need to just shoot the sword. Many people have told me that the sword is primarily defensive, and don't do the swirl. Like, the swirl is actually just bad. So we should just be instead shooting it. And hopefully it carries, like, a damage bonus associated with it, because, you know, by itself it's not really killing it here. So we need four spirit hearts in reserve in order to get the, door open on the next floor. Oh! Tier homed in quite nicely. That's gotta be our secret room, so let's get that... sorted. Alright, now we're at four spirit hearts, so don't use it again. Although we may want to give some money there to... Maybe we should just swing? Like, maybe we don't even want to charge it? But we have to get so close to enemies, we're gonna lose so many, tiers up, luck down. Honestly, keeping us at zero luck is not the end of the world. If you drop me down a negative one, then I start to get a little ornery, but... And tiers up is probably good, I suppose, I don't know. I don't know how often we can shoot with this thing. Hook me up. Beautiful. I mean, I'm not going to the shop anyway, so... Might as well take another fire. And zap me. That's okay. That didn't hurt, though. It should have hurt, but it did not hurt. So we only need two bombs. Number one. I'm assuming our range can't actually be lowered. So what do we care about getting, like, a huge... shot speed increase. Or not shot speed, huge tier rate increase. I think we should be stoked to have a huge tier rate increase. 34 minutes into a run. Finally starting to pop off. That appears to be the The Isaac experience in 2017 is that it takes a little longer to make it work, but... You know, that's what happens in old age. You know, the body's willing, probably. The mind is willing, but the body's spongy and weak. Can't remember how the phrase goes. Either way, we got two keys to finish it off. We got the Spirit Hearts in reserve. We got 5 HP. Good damage, good DPS. I don't know what the fuck's going on with the sword, but we took it anyway because we're weird. And we will use 2 bombs to... Oh, that door was open. I saw it. We'll use 2 bombs to go down here. And big thing, just avoid a false sense of security. Very easy to fall into a false sense of security here. Look at the items we got. But it would be the wrong decision. Because the mines are a terrible thing to get wasted on. I tried to make that more eloquent. It did not work. So that gives you a rotten heart. Hear me out here. Yuck heart. Gives us a rotten heart. I think it's way more useful for us to be getting flies. They are spectral. It's way more useful for us to be getting flies than it is for us to be getting fires. Surprisingly difficult sentence to say. Oh, I shouldn't have done that. Okay, we now we made it interesting because I made it so I have to get some spirit hearts. Let's make that happen. Because I'm dumb. Come on. I'm not suggesting that it's likely we're going to establish a fly army. That sentence is surprisingly tough. However, you know, the more yuck hearts we have, the more flies we're going to summon at the end of every room. I think, unless the way that they work is you just summon 2 per room, no matter what. Like, if you, as long as you have a yum heart, you summon 2 per room. I think it doesn't work like that. I think it summons 2 per room for every single yuck heart that you have. Yeah, we'll take that. Which is why I'm stacking up as many as is possible here. Because I want to basically create, like, a bullshit fly army for myself. And I have to be honest with you, so far it's working gangbusters. We do want a bomb, because we want more spirit arts. I don't actually know if we need more spirit arts. What I do know is that I won't be going to the arcade. Yeah, I think we're summoning 2 per room. Maybe it's 1 per room per fly, but it's still good. You know, summoning 5 flies per room is basically like a better guppy's head. So I won't be going to the arcade because I don't want to, because I don't want to. Is this Mines 2? It is Mines 2. So we should get our knife piece just before we forget. But the other thing is, I think it's just the wrong play to go to the, arcade. Because what are we looking for? If we find a blood bank, at least before we get charged, wow, that was bad. Before we get charged, we will lose our ability to create flies here. So I want to slow my roll a little bit. We did fuck up our deal chance, but not by much. So we definitely should have enough spirit arts to get into this room now. Just remember to spam shots. I think we're honestly pretty lucky that it's Great Gideon. Do we have to complete a spin or something? Like, I mean, with a homing shot, we should really just be patient. Presumably, Daddy Longlegs is going to do a lot of the work for me as well. Oh, there's 2 of these guys left. That explains it. No! I saw it! I had it tracked on the way in, and yet I could knock it out of the way. That's okay. We're still going to be, Are you kidding me that that shot couldn't figure out how to home into the spiders over here? We're still going to have an 82% chance of getting some kind of deal. Thank you, flies. Thank you. Hopefully this counts as a doubled room as well. Okay, just don't throw. You're doing fine. Daddy Longlegs is honestly saving me a lot of heartache. That we're pretty much just blessed to be able to avoid. Where's the next wave? Oh, it is right next to us. Okay. Daddy long legs. We did it. We blocked him. Total skill. Total skill. That didn't hit. Okay, we got him. We did not. We got him. We got him. Okay, so we get the tiers upgrade. We actually got to deal with the devil. Amazingly enough, the tiers upgrade is not really a tiers upgrade. Dude, as far as I'm concerned, this is sweet. We don't ruin our deal with the angel chance. And we get a lump of coal, which I'm assuming is going to work for us. We got our knife piece, so we'll spend what we need to spend there. And then we'll... Oh, we don't have enough charges. Okay. So we'll head down here. That's pretty good. It's pretty good. This run is now at least applicable to YouTube. We can put it up on YouTube now. Now remember, we shouldn't be running into enemies with a sword. It's... Maybe for whatever reason, it's a hard habit for me to break. We are doing a lot more damage, I think, and a lot more, like, skillfully. With a lot less wasted when we handle things this way. Well... We should really be using... Like, this saving the spirit arts does us nothing, so... We want... Juicy Sack, I think, over Spider Babby. We also definitely want to go to the shop, so... It's another greed fight, of course. No problems there. Actually, that time we did not need to use the, we did not need to use the Yum Heart. I'm just gonna call it the Yum Heart, and now I'm gonna call it the Yuck Heart. I've worked my way through it, mentally speaking. So we're basically good to go to the shop here, and, only a 40% chance of a deal. Oh, you know why? Because we gave up the Book of Virtue. And that's something I hadn't really considered, but also something I'm hoping is not really going to factor in. I think it's worth giving up one deal without a doubt. Unquestionably, objectively, worth giving up one deal to switch to the Yuck card. Is it worth giving up two deals if it comes to that? Is it worth giving up three deals if it comes to that? I don't know, but we also, like... In taking that hit, we were not affected. Our deal with the devil chance wasn't affected, I mean to say. Daddy Longlegs, one more, please. No! That's my bad. We get HP. Whiffed on our 40% chance. Life goes on. More HP is great because we get more opportunities to fill up with Yuck Hearts. And again, the only thing that concerns me is fucking it up so bad that we lose all of our Yuck Hearts before the final boss fight and thus generate no flies for a while. Right now, we're not even losing our Yuck Hearts to begin with. So honestly, it's like having an extra Spirit Heart backing us up, but our deal chance has gotten even lower. Yeah, we'll take Sack of Pennies, but both of those are bad options. Sack of Pennies, unlikely to provide us with anything of value. And, you know, whatever that voodoo item is, I can never remember. Just gives us the ability to teleport, which is not as good. Well, it's actually pretty okay, I think, if you have a spacebar item. Or if you don't have a spacebar item. If you do have a spacebar item, I think it's horrible. Usually, it's going to lose to other spacebar items that are consciously, you know, curated and picked up. So this is the way to go to get to the... boss fight. It is going to skip the shop, but I'm honestly at the end of my rope when it comes to dealing with this floor, and I want to get down to the corpse so that I can get more items as soon as possible. So I'm probably going to skip the shop. I may go back on that deal. We'll see. I also just want to I want to see if we get a deal right off the bat. I know full well, of course, that if we do get a deal, well, whether or not we get a deal, we're not going to be able to leave. But I'm assuming as well, and you know, this could be false, but I'm assuming that that is going to be our knife room down here. Honestly, a golden chest next to Small Rock is like the best payout we could expect to get here, so... This guy's making poop everywhere he goes. It's a new one. This is the knife room. I think I'm just gonna book it, honestly. I'm pretty stoked that we're alive and looking relatively well right now. Kinda just wanna fight the boss, go down to the corpse, and see if we can finagle a victory out of this run. And yeah, the strength card's good. I think I prefer High Priestess, probably saving it for the corpse fight unless we get something, or sorry, the witness fight, unless we get something a little better. Or maybe we'll use it on the first corpse boss fight just to make it as easy as possible. So, kind of whiffed on our angel chance there, or devil chance for that matter. I need to play more Antibirth to, yes, precisely to memorize when those brimstone shots come out. There's an obvious tell. It's just hard to focus on it when you're used to focusing on different things in the fight. Still made it. Definitely gonna take the Polaroid. Right, don't just walk into it. Doing fine. Daddy Longlegs is gonna save us some hassle here. I don't know why I thought if I had a fully charged sword, we could not be hit. Oh my god, we're gonna be killed. Well, High Priestess does nothing for us, so time to dodge, motherfucker. We're not safe here! We're not safe! I know, Ruka, it's maddening! The difficulty spike is like wimp, wimp, wham! Like it goes, it's a freaking, it's like my death coaster. Damn, dude, we tried. Sincerely, we tried. For now, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed the episode. I'll be back with another one tomorrow, as always. If you did, click the like button. It helps out a great deal. Of course, subscribe if you want to see more in the future. But for now, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.